Hi guys, so based on the discussion on the previous video about different products and how do we make different products, it kind of leads me to another question we get a lot, and that's how do these work? What is the point of a multi-column store? What is it that they do and that they accomplish? Now, what you need to understand is, as we discussed on the previous video, you can make different products by just distilling in different percentages. Now, the determining factor of purity, the percentage of the distillate coming out of the still, is something that we call reflux. Now, reflux is the cycles of evaporation and condensation that happens during a distillation process. And the more of these cycles, the more reflux, the higher the purity. Now, if you look at the old style stills, the Olympic style stills, that would be based on the section over here, where you have a boiler and you have what we call a vapor chamber on top of it. This vapor chamber determined the reflux. This vapor chamber determined the purity of the product that came out the other side. So the taller the vapor chamber, the more surface area exposed inside the vapor chamber, and the greater the temperature differential between the boiler and the vapor, top of the vapor chamber, all of these factors influence the reflux ratio. But there's a limit to the purity you can achieve just by playing around with the vapor chamber. So people decided to do all kinds of different things to figure out how to get higher purity. But putting it through the still, there's only so much you can do with this type of design, this original Olympic style design, to increase purity. Even if you're putting in thumpers and other types of additions to the still, there's a limit. Those of you familiar with the phase diagrams, if you've done training with us before, you know there's a reduction in rate of purity return as you redistill. And just because it doesn't become practical anymore to put it through a still again and again and again. The whole double distilled, triple distilled, seven times distilled argument. So in a still like this, we're dealing with two different types of reflux. We've got internal reflux, which is determined by the configuration, the number of plates, the number of sections inside the still, and we've got adjustable reflux. Now there's two types of adjustable reflux. In an adjustable reflux column still, we have adjustable reflux based on distillate flow control. However, in a fractionating reflux column still, or multi-column still like this one, we have adjustable reflux based on coolant flow control. This section over here, which we call the main reflux condenser, some countries they refer to it as a deflagonator. This is where we adjust the purity of our distillate, or the purity of our product, by controlling water flow, coolant flow, through this section over here, increasing or decreasing the reflux depending on what I want to make. So how do I use this still? So let's say I want to do a stripping run, where I want to turn my fermentation into low wines for long-term storage or for redistillation at a later stage. Then I just send it up through the Olympic vapor chamber, send it across to my condenser, and I strip my run off. If, however, I want to make a brandy, or fruit brandy and Mampur, a very flavorful product, and I want to distill at a low percentage, about 60 to 70%, then I need a bit more reflux, because this won't give me that purity. This also won't allow me to give that increased recovery rate, because we use the main reflux condenser to improve our recovery rate. By purifying the heads and pushing down the tails, we get more usable alcohol out. That's what's the benefit, what the big benefit is of the main reflux condenser, the increased recovery rate. So I want, relatively speaking, low purity, but I want it consistent. I want to do my entire run between 60 and 70%, and I want to get maximum recovery rate. So I send it up through the Olympic head, down through four plates, each plate being a distillation, giving me higher purity consistency, the main reflux allowing me to stabilize, purify, increase my recovery rate, and maintain a certain percentage alcohol, and from there it goes through to the spirit condenser. If I want to do a whiskey type product, where I want to distill at 70 to 80%, maybe up to 85%, then I send it up, through, down, through eight plates, in fact eight levels of distillation, and over to the condenser. Again, using the main reflux condenser at the top to purify, maintain consistency, and increase my recovery rate. If I want to make vodka, where I want a high purity, 90 to 95% distillation strength to distill all the flavor and taste, then I send it up, across, down, through four plates, over, down, through another eight plates. So in effect, 12 times distilled. You can still apply either one or both of the main reflux condensers to increase recovery rate and maintain purity. And I send it to the spirit condenser. And lastly, if I want to do gin in this still, I send it up, straight across, down, through the ginning basket, which contains my botanicals, We also have botanicals in the bottom of the boiler. There's a jacketed boiler with an agitator, so I can put botanicals in the boiler itself, and comes through to the spirit condenser, giving me my distillate. So I keep saying every plate being a distillation. Does that mean triple distilled, went for three plates, double distilled, I mean two plates? Well, this is where it gets a bit tricky. Traditionally, it referred to how many times was it gone through a still. Technology changed. We are now able to achieve high purity, maintain high purity without putting it through a still multiple times. So in some countries, there's legal equivalencies where I distill between a certain percentage and a certain percentage. It's the legal equivalent of double distilled. Certain percentage and another percentage, legal equivalent of three times distilled or seven times distilled, whatever the case may be. In South Africa, however, we have no such legal equivalency. So what does it mean in South Africa if it says double or triple distilled? To be completely honest with you, the jury's out at the moment. Because our law has no distinction for double and triple distilled, the only fallback position in our law is Article 12 of the National Liquor Products Act regulation. And what Article 12 says is that whatever's on the label must be factually correct. It may not be misleading. But now there's a problem. If I run it through a still twice, that is factually correct, that is a double distillation. However, if I run it through four plates, that is also factually correct if I claim four times distilled. So either way, technically speaking, is correct. So how do you define when something is double distilled or triple distilled, four times distilled? Do you claim the number of plates or do you claim the number of runs through a still? So at the moment, the Department of Agriculture can't give us a definitive answer on this. They are still trying to decide. My personal opinion, my fallback position is, it comes down to the consumer. And the average consumer does not know about plates, does not know about reflux. So an average consumer reading a bottle, seeing double distilled, triple distilled, seven times distilled, their personal perception is it was run through a still that many times. And that should be the guiding factor. But at the moment, legally speaking, there is no definitive answer on that. It's taken on a case-by-case basis. So again, know the law, know what should be on the label. That way you know what you're drinking. Thanks a lot.